Good afternoon, my dear brothers and sisters in Christ. Thank you for joining me in this channel once again. Today is Saturday of the 32nd week in ordinary time. And the topic of our reflection today is never give up on prayers. For many Christians, prayer is like work. When asked to pray, they grumble as though they are asked to carry bags of cement. While for many of us, as soon as we begin to pray, immediately we doze off. This is a very serious problem. We are like children living abroad who grumble when asked to speak to their parents at home. I have heard many persons who claim that this attitude to prayer is a sign of demonic spiritual arrest. But this is a pure lie. The strategy of our modern day men and women of God is to make demons look so powerful in the eyes of the people. This is how they get to control reasonable individuals by making them believe that they are under bondage, except the very rich individuals, of course. And that every ethic is a result of demonic forces. The real bondage is being a member of a church whose pastor does not talk about the power of God, but is always talking about the power of demons, as if to say he or she is a member of Satan's cult. We do not enjoy prayer because we do not understand prayer. We do not know that prayer is our moment of intimacy with God. We do not pray because we do not know how much power we wield simply by mentioning the name of Jesus alone. We do not pray because we rush our prayers. We do not apply faith to every word we use at prayer. We have prayed wrongly in the past and did not get what we were praying for. So as pragmatic individuals, we give up on prayer and we begin to believe the lies of the devil that prayer does not work. Dear friends, the greatest obstacle against our prayer life is to have a utilitarian attitude or approach to prayer. Prayer is not a tool. It is in itself a nourishment for our lives, physically, psychologically, and above all, spiritually. Prayer is therapy. Prayer is medicine. Prayer is the best health tip anyone can give to you. Prayer is fun. Prayer is life. When we pray, we should not be so concerned about the outcome of prayer. Rather, we should enjoy communion with God. We should approach prayer just the way a newlywed couple would approach the marriage bed. In today's gospel passage, Jesus used the parable of the unjust judge to teach us the importance of persistence in prayer. Never give up on prayer. Forget about solving your problems and just worship God, as our psalmist today sings. Remember the wonders the Lord has done. Never forget his good deeds. Deliberately, remember what God has done for you already and show appreciation. That should be the beginning of prayer. To remember all that God has done for you, begin with showing appreciation. The book of Wisdom, where our first reading today comes from, sings of the glory of God in creation. One good way to begin praying is to just examine the beauty of nature, the wonder of creation, the rhythm of morning and evening, the trees, the rivers, the sun, the rain, the stars, the atmosphere around you. Think of these things and think of the one who created and sustains them all. You will naturally slide into prayer. In the end, if the only prayer you ever say is thank you, it will be enough. May God bless his words in our hearts. Amen.